fabricated can be assembled quickly and easily. Each module of the house is complete and needs only to be attached to adjoining modules. Furthermore, it would be easier to follow the logic of the construction in blocks or modules rather than a board and nail at a time. You could code a small, simple program at machine level, but when a program is expanded to hundreds or thousands of instructions, machine coding generally becomes much too tedious. A coding method which is easier to learn and use can help solve some programming problems of this nature. So recognizable words or mnemonic names are used in machine-level instruction sets. Mnemonic, if the word is new to you, means memory aid. Now, for example, these groups of binary digits represent the instruction for adding a number to a stored value. These mnemonic words can accomplish the same purpose and are much easier to understand and code. This is a fundamental characteristic of a low-level language. Symbols have been substituted for numbers in a simple form of symbolic language. A direct relationship exists between the names and the machine code. Each line of symbolic code corresponds to one machine instruction. This parallel form of coding is called an assembly language. An assembly language is used instead of actual machine code to create programs. Thus, coding is faster, easier, and more accurate using symbols instead of numbers. In effect, mnemonic, low-level, symbolic, and assembly mean much the same thing. But the computer can't execute instructions composed of symbols. It can't digest them. Only code that directly represents machine instructions is acceptable to the hardware. The symbols are easily understood by humans, but not by the computer. The symbols of a low-level language must be translated or converted to machine instructions by an assembler program. An assembler program is a translator which changes a source program written in assembly language into machine language. The mnemonic names or symbols we create in our source program are assembled into a machine-usable form. But since computers differ from model to model in their design, one manufacturer's machine may have different machine instructions from those of another manufacturer. The mnemonic symbols of each assembly language may also be different. It's even possible that one company will manufacture different models that do not use the same instructions in assembler programs. However, identical machines can use duplicate assembler programs. They're usually supplied to users by the manufacturer. All users of a given computer model are provided with the same assembler program. Thus, it is quite possible for a program coded at an installation in Denver to be assembled on a like machine in Miami. Successful use of common assembler programs depends on machines having the same electronic circuits. Therefore, assembler programs are referred to as being machine-dependent. This may present problems. Suppose an expanding organization requires a new computer. The assembler programs coded for the old computer, since they are machine dependent, probably would have to be rewritten in order to use them on the new computer. This recoding could be minimized by developing a common language for communication with different types of computers. Much of the cost and time required in conversion to a new machine could be saved. High-level programming languages are one means of achieving this common communication. Programs coded in a high-level programming language can be used on any computer having a compiler for that language. A compiler is designed to perform on a specific type of machine for a specific language. Perhaps an analogy will make this clear. If a construction foreman gave orders in English to French and German workmen, they wouldn't understand them. But if the foreman's instructions were relayed by translators in each worker's own language, the job would be done. If you coded "move new balance to report line" for computer A and computer B, the compilers for the machines would produce different machine instructions, but their effect would be the same. The compiler will accept high-level language programs, analyze the statements, then organize the equivalent elementary machine instructions, such as add, subtract, compare, and move to solve a wide variety of problems. Put another way, a compiler is a complex program which accepts a source program in symbolic language as input data and produces an object program in the form of machine instructions as its output. This translation is necessary because today's computers can't accept source statements directly. Early computers had all instructions wired into the circuitry. Each different program was actually a control panel or board which had to be rewired to change the program. These computers had very limited instruction sets and performed simple functions. Modern computers have logic modules, such as printed circuit cards or tiny silicone chips, that are very similar in concept to the old boards. They are a permanent part of the computer's logic and are considered part of its hardware. In order for a computer to use source statements directly without compiling, its circuitry or hardware would have to be able to translate source coding into machine language. The hardware would have to be modified every time a change was made to the source language. The same physical modification would have to be made to every computer of the same model. It's cheaper and more efficient to change a single compiler program. Now, let's clear up a point here. Are compilers and assemblers the same thing? Descriptions of their functions sound very similar. The primary difference is that an assembler translates instructions one for one. That is, each coded instruction becomes a single machine instruction. In a high-level language, a single instruction is translated into many machine instructions. For example, in the basic language, the sentence B equals P times Q plus C describes several actions: load, multiply, add, and store. The compiler generates all the machine instructions required. High-level languages are machine-independent because compilers make them understandable to the computer. Compared to an assembly language, a high-level language is easier to learn. It's easier to write, requiring fewer statements, and easier to remember. The symbols and mnemonic names make coding easier to read and understand. And because the computer adapts the program to most machine requirements, the program logic is easier to follow. A problem written in a high-level language may be easier to debug. And because a high-level language provides some documentation with its notational format, it is not only easier to follow, but adding one more easier to our list, easier to change. And now, some characteristics are common to all languages, high or low level. Both have syntactic and semantic rules. The rules of syntax tell a programmer how statements must be coded so the compiler can translate a source program into an object program. Each computer language has its own rules: spelling, punctuation, codes, and formats. These rules must be followed precisely, and the compiler will generate appropriate error messages when the rules are broken.